The Kampala Capital City Authority has abandoned plans to purchase eco-buses for the modern transport system to enhance transport efficiency in the city. The revelation was made by the KCCA Executive Director Dorothy Kisaka while meeting the Parliamentary Committee on National Economy, which is currently assessing performance of government projects that are funded by loans. Kisaka noted that they were guided by the President to abandon the purchase of 50 eco-buses and channel the funds to three road projects, including Pererekiti, 10.7 kilometers, Ntinda Chisasi, 2.7 kilometers, and Bukoto Ntinda, 1.8 kilometers.
Projection is there on the PowerPoint. The Pererekiti Road, Ntinda Chisasi, and Bukoto Ntinda Road, 15.2. Old Kira Road, which is at the back, is a proposed. Because sometimes when there are savings within the budget, some roads which are already designed can be done, but it's not covered in that money.
The purchase of 50 eco-buses was under the $288 million Kampala City Roads Rehabilitation Project to enhance transport efficiency in Kampala. They were planned to cost $12 million. However, committee members protested diversion of funds on grounds that KCCA was not cleared by Parliament, which approved the government to acquire this loan from African Development Bank.
You were advised by the President. We had Parliament is saying we need the eco buses.
Thank you, Chair.
So in order to cancel that, you know, this rope, and when you change program, notify your political head. Let the political head notify Parliament.
It is very unfortunate that KCCA is abandoning a project which Parliament has best on to approve a funding, like a loan. There are a number of reasons why we okay or approve funds.
MPs asked KCCA to furnish the committee with evidence that they were cleared by the bank to divert funds from procurement of eco-buses to road reconstruction.
We are closing a sensitive part instead of saying, because if we ask for the total amount of money that was supposed to buy the eco-buses, and everybody is aware KCCA is going to buy buses, we are only going to tell them today that according to KCCA, buses are not there.
We need the documents that they notified the bank and the bank agreed.
Yes.
Yeah, because that is very, very key.
Meanwhile, the committee queried KCCA over shoddy works on roads, drainage channels and traffic lights done under the Kampala Institutional and Infrastructure Development Project.
A lot of money has been pumped in the drainage, but we keep on seeing Kampala getting flooded. Why? This is a lot of money. And two, this committee had a privilege to go to Kigali. Have you people gone there?
I have always been wondering, do we have experts in this KCCA? Do we really have these experts? Are they doing their job? Or are they openly corrupt? Or are they simply sabotaging work of government?
Legislators also questioned KCCA over alleged inflation of the unit cost of roads in Kampala. But KCCA blamed it on the high cost of land compensations.
And even the lighting we are talking about on Nakawa side. To be honest, if you move there and look at value for money, it's not something you can stand proud of and say this is what we have done with the money.
I'm not like Alex. Who is appreciating what KCCA has done. Personally, I have not appreciated the chair. So that is why I want to reserve my word.
The committee also questioned the loss of over $17 million, which is approximately 62 billion shillings in poundage by KCCA. According to KCCA, while securing the $175 million loan from the International Development Association, $17.08 million, which is 9.76%, was not disbursed due to exchange loss. But MPs were not satisfied with the explanation and wondered why all this money was lost in forex exchange, yet it would have been used on road construction.
This loss of $17 million, KCCA having highlighted it here, I think you have something special or something unique you want to really explain to this committee?
This explanation can be best talked about by Minister of Finance, because when Minister of Finance is borrowing, we borrow in dollars.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.